and now to the politics of fasting in India. After the Congress, it's now Prime Minister Narendra Modi and the BJP President Amit Shah who've announced that they're going on fasts. Theirs is against the opposition's disruptions during the budget session of Parliament. So the politics of fasting are unending in India. Remember, the Congress had gone on a fast recently. It's now the ruling party's or the Bharatiya Janata Party's chief and President Amit Shah and the Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi himself who have decided to go on a fast. This against the opposition's disruptions during the budget session of Parliament. Right, let me go across to WION's political editor, Karthikeya Sharma. He's joining us live from the newsroom. Karthikeya, fast after fast, but really speaking, what's achieved from all of it?
See, what has happened is that I think in the context of the fast which the Congress had kept, but though it became very controversial, Prime Minister Narendra Modi, and Amit Shah wants to keep a fast to show that the parliament did not function and they want to make an issue out of it. Now, and I think the reason why they have used fast as a medium to push the point across is because the Congress fast which took place was a bit of a fiasco because Sajjan Kumar and Titler walked up and then there was a photograph of a couple of senior leaders eating chole bhature before the fast. So I think they want to keep that that fast controversy alive. So I think it is in that context that this is being done. There is no other context because I don't see any parliamentarian keeping a fast after the parliament has been a washout, because it's also the responsibility of the Treasury, which is the ruling dispensation. It's not only the responsibility of the opposition parties. I remember on the issue of JPC, the parliament did not run for 60 days.
Right.
So it happened. So I think this is in context of the fast which Congress did or the organized, but created more controversy than content.
I think also, would it be safe to say, Karthikeya, that the government does find itself on the back foot? You know, there have been a number of situations cropping up almost on a regular basis. Just today, of course, the BJP chief minister in Uttar Pradesh has also got a lot of people gunning for him. This could be a diversionary tactic as well.
I think, you know, I would say that more than diversionary tactic, I think they just want to create the contrast between the fiasco which happened on the day when Congress organized the fast, which is 9th, and when they are doing it. And I think they want to just keep those memories fresh. I think it's just about the creating those binaries. If the controversy wouldn't have existed, I think the Congress fast would have just communicated the message very simply, but it could not. So I think I would just see it in that context, because what really surprises me is that no one does fast after the session is over. If that was the concern, then the people in power should have fasted in Parliament itself to ensure that the people come. So I think the intent is different.
But the timing can't be ignored. Has this happened during the last 4 years, or do you think this is desperate times calling for desperate measures?
I don't think it has happened in last 4 years or even 14 years for Prime Minister to fast on such an issue. My understanding is that since this is 2018, after May, you know, it becomes the Lok Sabha year, you know, it becomes the year of elections. I think they're getting into the election mode, the Lok Sabha mode.